So in the last few videos, I described to you this cell design for a hit cell, which was developed by Sanyo, and it was a big hit for them. This cell achieves one of the highest VOCs that is possible for a crystalline silicon cell. It also achieves the efficiencies of more than 22% on large area cells. But this cell design, it didn't just happen by accident. So I'm a history buff. I like to look at, you know, how inventions they get originated and how they're developed. So Sanyo was a company which back in the 1970s, late 70s and 80s was working on these thin film silicon cells made out of amorphous silicon. And then they started working on these crystalline silicon cells. And the research for this hit cell started in the mid 90s. The first commercial cell was, I think, developed in 1997. But they were a company which had expertise in both amorphous silicon and crystalline silicon. So they were very appropriately placed to develop this hit cell, which utilizes both this crystalline silicon cell and then this amorphous silicon cell for passivation of the surface. So, you know, this Sanyo at that time and at that place was uniquely positioned to develop this technology. So in this video, I want to, you know, give you some more context into some unique advantages which come along because of this hit cell architecture. So one thing that I already mentioned was that this cell can be processed at a low temperature. This whole processing of this can be completed at very low temperature as compared to conventional cell, which require a temperature of more than 800 degrees centigrade. So as a result of that, there's way less damage caused in the crystalline silicon. So usually if you subject your low-grade silicon to high temperature processes, there's a defect formation, cluster formation, which happens inside the cell. But since the processing of the cell is completed at a very low temperature, it benefits from the absence of these high temperature process which cause defects. So in this video, I want to mention some of the unique features which this hit cell has. So one of the unique feature which is often publicized by Sanyo, or now Panasonic, which acquired Sanyo, is that the low temperature coefficient for this hit cell. So as we in one of the previous videos, I described that the efficiencies of a solar cell, they fall as a function of temperature. So when you increase the temperature, your efficiency typically falls. And the reason for that is your current, essentially your generation recombination current, goes up. It's usually given by this formula, where this temperature, power dependence of temperature, comes due to the density of state. And this dependence comes due to the lowering of the barrier height as you increase the temperature. So usually you can express the current in your solar cell by this formula, where it's given by the short circuit current minus this recombination current, and this rises exponentially as a function of voltage. And one can equate the current to zero to find the VOC. So one can do that to find the open circuit voltage. And then you could differentiate the open circuit voltage with respect to temperature to find its temperature dependence. So you get, if you do that, you'll get this formula, where this temperature coefficient of VOC, so this VOC, as you see, it has a negative temperature dependence. So usually when you increase your temperature, your VOC decreases. And this is what is the primary driver of your efficiency decreasing as a function of temperature. So if you look at this, formula, this temperature dependence of VOC, it depends upon how, you know, it depends upon, if you look at just these two terms, It depends upon the difference between the VOC and the band gap of the cell. So the higher is my VOC, or the higher is my open circuit voltage, the closer it would be to the band gap of the cell. So that would mean that I'll have less temperature coefficient. So the higher the VOC, the less is the difference between these two terms, and that would give me a lower temperature dependence. So because of the low surface recombination velocity in achieved in this head cell, because of this good passivation between my amorphous silicon and the crystalline silicon at the surface, as a result of that, my I01 is lower, or my VOC is higher. My VOC is, in fact, in head cell, it's more than 0.7 EV, and that brings essentially that reduces this term. As a result of that, the VOC decrease as a function of temperature reduces. So the heat cell essentially it has a very good temperature coefficient for efficiency. So in a normal crystalline silicon-based cell, your efficiency decreases by approximately 0.45% for every degree increase in the temperature. So if you have 10 degree increase in the operating temperature of the cell, your efficiency would decrease by 4.5%. In comparison to that, the heat cell has roughly a temperature dependence of half of that. So if for a heat cell, the temperature dependence of efficiency is only 0.23% decrease per degree increase in temperature. So if I, in this case, if I increase the temperature by 10 degree centigrade, my efficiency only decreases by 2.3%. So that makes these heat cells very favorable for operation in high temperature conditions, where are in deserts or places where you're operating these cells at high temperature. So they'll have much better efficiencies as compared to these crystalline silicon cell. Another very unique feature of this head design, which I find very interesting, is this design, is that this design is essentially symmetric as compared to whether you use the cell from the top or whether you use from the bottom. Actually, I should not say it's symmetric, but the cell could be functional whether you use it from the top. If you use it from the top, it would be essentially a N. If let's say this crystalline silicon is N minus, so it would be a N N minus P cell, versus if you use it from the bottom, it would be a P N minus N cell. So one could optimize the cell such that it could be used both in the cases where light falls from the top and light falls from the top from the bottom. And usually these bus bars or these fingers, these contacts which are placed on the top and the bottom, they're also placed they're also placed symmetrically. So you could utilize the cell both using it from the front or using it from the back. That renders this cell to be very useful for some unique applications where you have availability of light both from the top and from the bottom. For example, given here are some scenarios in which this might be possible. So for example, you're mounting these panels on this at this slanted angle, and you're mounting them on a roof which is which is let's say which you had colored white, so it has very good reflectivity. So you could be capturing these sunlight which is coming directly from the sun, but this roof which is white in color can also essentially reflect this light from the surface, and this could be incident from the backside of the cell. Similarly, one you could also place them vertically. But a very useful scenario would be, when these things are horizontally mounted, but they're mounted at a height. So instead of placing this directly on a surface, you place it, for example, at a particular height away from the surface. And now when this surface is highly reflective, it could essentially, you know, reflect this light, which is coming again from the cell, and reflect it back to the cell. So this makes for very interesting applications of this hit cell, and now it's called the hit double cell. So it could double the hit with some pun intended for this design. And I'm showing here one of the designs that I particularly find interesting. So this is the Walt Disney Studio, which is located in Burbank in California. And if you visit them, they have this solar panels installed on the roof of the studio, but they also have this walkway on the, you know, connecting two different buildings of the studio. So this makes a very good sample case, example case for illustrating this hit double design. So as you can see over here, this panels are mounted on top of this walkway, but this is a small, you know, this is a narrow walkway, and these panels are mounted at quite some height. So this makes a very good, you know, a case where your sunlight can hit these panels directly from the top, but it could also come and hit this walkway, and if this walkway is highly reflective, it can essentially reflect this back to these solar panels, and these solar panels can now essentially absorb light from the bottom because they're using this hit double design. So this could, depending upon how much light you can shine on this cell from the bottom, this can again increase your efficiency depending upon, and it's highly subjective, you know, how these are mounted and how these are what is the structure and what is the reflection of all these surfaces, but you could increase your efficiency easily by 20 to 30% by using this double kind of design under some of these scenarios.